Heyo everyone, this is a Happy Anime Cafe Manager here with another Let's Play for Fire Emblem Three Houses. Alright, another support log with Lawrence. I've been getting more complaints. The girls actually do seem bothered.
Professor, I assure you, you have been deceived. My adversary has poisoned the hearts of these ladies against me. The plot goes deeper than I thought.
There's no conspiracy, this is real. This could be a serious issue. So, commoners are excluded.
Typically, yes. Even if others are sometimes critical of that notion. For the nobility, marriage is not merely a union of individuals. It is also a union of families. It would not benefit House Gloucester to be tied to a family of powerless commoners, would it? To achieve supremacy, it is necessary for my life to be tied to that influential family. That is the best path to peace and prosperity for all. So, as you can see, the future of the Alliance rests on my shoulders.
That's a remarkable responsibility. That's quite an obligation.
It is nothing out of the ordinary. Those of us with noble blood are born to this duty, you know. That being said, to avoid misunderstandings, I shall restrain myself until things calm down. I would rather not cause trouble for you, after all.
Ash's birthday. Yeah, kind of weird I'd be hosting a guy tea party for a guy. Yeah, that kid's been through some shit because of the whole Lenato incident. Monastery Mysteries. You're doing great work. Things haven't gone. Things went amiss. Alright, good.
How's
to learn Seraphim. Okay, Lucidia learned Seraphim. You have allies who could take advanced exams. Take a look at the certifications of which they could take. Looks like it could advance to assassin. Still need to work on all my other skills. Like, how do I become a hero class? Get Swordfare advantage. That's what I'm looking for. As for flame, I don't have a spare beginner seal marketplace. Class. She's already an intermediate class. Yeah, sorry, but I gotta have her work her way up just like everyone else. She's good. She looks like a red mage. Okay, let's Cynthia. She's good enough to make it to advanced class. Got the odds of passing 65%. Warlock. But her reason needs to be at A. And she's so close to that. Raise up a lot of support logs from all those battles. Okay, you could start using spells again. Because I need him to be my Dark Knight. Oh, look, looks like he knocked his right for an intermediate test. So just advance him to Archer. Bolt range plus one. Okay, cool. So what's gonna change? Attack reduced by one, movement by one, luck by two, dexterity by two. A noble and powerful leader, this class excels at wielding sword and has a high degree of authority. So now he's an archer. Claude and Lawrence.
Claude, are you aware of the most recent conflict within the Alliance? Oh, you do, Lawrence. And you don't have to be more specific. The Alliance is always bickering over one thing. Margaret and Edmund is raising objections over the assignment of his troops to the Eastern Defenses. If you please one noble, another will be great. No matter what happens, there will always be one. That is just the kind of lackadaisical attitude that causes more conflict among us than necessary. Now, listen to me carefully. craftsmen he assembled that the fortress is now so impregnable. I, for one, would want to attack a fortress as formidable as that.
I do see your point. If House Edmund has already made it to their contribution, then that is all we can ask. Very well. I withdraw my objection. But the sturdiest fortress needs soldiers to defend it. If we continue to squabble amongst ourselves, it will eventually fall.
Well, well. And here I thought he only cared about stats. Still, if someone like him really came to lead the Alliance, not bode well for an alignment.
And with Tilda.
What are you writing there, Hilda? Wait, let me guess. You're replying to one of your Rucker letters, right?
Of course. It's a pain, but I make sure to always send him a response. Otherwise, he'll worry. It's much easier than when we live together. A few letters here and there are a small price to pay for this peaceful, brotherly environment.
Well, that's a fine thing to do, regardless of your reasons. As for me, it's been far too long since I've written my parents.
Oh, I thought your father had died.
Not quite. He's still alive and kicking, as far as I know. The late Duke who died in an accident was my uncle.
I see. I do recall you mentioning that your mother was born into the Regan family. What's your father like, if you don't mind me asking?
He's quite the extravagant character. When I was a kid, he used to tie me to a horse and drag me around.
Excuse me?
In all fairness, I was quite on crack. The horse thing sounds worse than this. There's some sort of trick to it.
A trick I hope I never need to learn. Your mother didn't step in and make him stop?
Gods, no. She just laughed right along with him. If my father is extravagant, my mother's more like a warrior goddess, or maybe a demon queen. In this one time, she got into an argument with my combat instructor and wound up full-on fist point. What's more, she won. My instructor was a mighty warrior, undefeated in 100 battles. Even he was no match for her.
Huh? But your mother is a lady of nobility.
True, but she was the kind of woman to elope with the man she loved and throw it all away. Not your average duchess at all.
Ooh, the eloped! I like that. It's so romantic. Imagine abandoning your family forever to be with the one you love. Not everyone can do that.
It's not a question of can, it's a question of will. Even someone like you who generally despises effort will pull out all the stops or something you don't care about. Isn't that right?
Excuse me? I put in plenty of effort.
Hey, that was a compliment. Anyhow, I look forward to the day when something inspires you to try your hand at the hardest.
Alright, Claude and Hilda. Reach B. Thanks for watching. Until next time, to be continued, baby.